great way. It's wonderful to be in the best hometown in the Army. That's Fort Leavenworth, and we couldn't be that without the community on post and off post. And so what you're going to get this morning is just a little piece of information from many of the directors or the service organizations or clubs that reside on the installation. And then we have several, whether it's Leavenworth, Lansing, Platte County, Atchison, we've got several of our partners that are going to be talking to you as well. So we'll try to be brief, but the great thing is we're going to keep this going. Like Johnny mentioned, we've got tables set up in the back. So after the briefers conclude, please stick around. They've got some information that they can further hand out. As you can see, this is the agenda on the slide. This is focused more of what we have on post. Next slide, please. And then these are our community partner presenters that are going to be talking with you today. So at this time, I'll turn it over to Colonel Shane Mendenhall. He's the Munson Army Health Center Commander. Shane, thank you for joining us this morning.
Good morning. Colonel Shane Mendenhall with Munson Army Health Center. For the Memorial Day holiday, we will be closed on the 29th, and then Monday, June 19th for Juneteenth, we will be closed as well based on the federal holiday schedule. And then something new this year based on where the 4th of July will be on the calendar on Tuesday, we will be closed on that Monday. So July 3rd and 4th, we will be closed and then reopen on the 4th. One of our new kind of emerging therapies that's in our rehab area is our pelvic floor therapy. A requirement is a referral, but you can also do a walk-in referral for that as well. So just something that's additive to our community and a requested rehabilitation that folks have asked for. So we're looking forward to that developing more and having more folks interested. And then the contraceptive care walk-in clinic hours are 08 to 1500 Monday through Friday. So, and then our mental health is located at Gentry Clinic, and then those hours are 07 to 1600 Monday through Friday, and then the crisis care is from 08 to 1500 as well. We do have a targeted care pilot program that is coming with our mental health, and what that allows for us to do is to do some triage. Look at the best resources that are on the installation. So we partner up with our MFLAX, our chaplain, with ACS, some other folks to ensure that we're getting our soldiers and family members out to the correct location for whether it's services or whether it's there at our mental health center. Other than that, that's really what we've got. And another key item down in that right-hand or left-hand corner is masks are no longer mandatory at Munson. We're aligned again with DOD policy as well as the CDC policy. So we're now tracking with that. Patients are more than welcome to wear their mask if they wish to, but at this point, no requirement for masks. So other than that, that's all I've got for this morning, and we'll go to the next slide.
Good morning, Fort Leavenworth. My name is Chaplain King. I'm the acting garrison chaplain. I have two pieces of information I'd like to share with you. The first is we will have a summer worship schedule that will start on the 11th of June, and that will continue through the 6th of August. Okay, the greatest impact that's going to have on our worship services will be at Memorial Chapel. The liturgical service will move to 0945. And the Episcopal Anglican service, it's going to turn into a prayer service on Wednesday night at 1700. Could I get the next slide? Can you believe it? We are less than 90 days out from Vacation Bible School. So that will occur the 1st through the 3rd of August. And we will begin our registration just after the 4th of July holiday. I'll be followed by Michael's Military Health.
Good morning, I'm Lee Brown. I'm the Resident Engagement Specialist at Frontier. families to live at Fort Leavenworth with us. We have utility costs included in our housing, along with 24-hour maintenance services. Volunteer is taking care of for you as well. In addition to active duty members, along with roommate options, we are also offering homes to DOD, DOJ workers, civilians, contractors, retirees, and civilians. With our historic and newer constructions, market rate villages, anyone can find a place to live at Fort Leavenworth. Next slide, please. So, living with us is more of just finding a home as a community. We take care of your home while you can experience all these things, beautiful Fort Leavenworth, all the activities that are provided for you on post, along with our award-winning schools, and then our location. Downtown Fort Leavenworth is beautiful, close to Kansas City and other events that you can get to within 30 minutes to an hour. So all these things combined makes living here with us at Fort Leavenworth and Frontier Heritage Communities a great experience for you all.
Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Keith Mispagel. I'm the superintendent for USD 207, the Fort Leavenworth School District. I have some information to share. Very exciting time of year for students, staff, and families. As we close out the school year, we are planning our first ever summer kickoff on May 19th at our track complex, right next to the golf course on Biddle and Cody, in partnership with FMWR. That'll be May 19th from 5 to 9. Bouncy houses, rides, games, food trucks. Looking forward to sharing that with all of our students and families. Biggest question we're getting this time of year from current families and incoming families is in regards to enrollment in our school district. The best information I can share is on our website, www.usd207.org, is all the information that you need for completing online enrollment, and it is done completely online for the initial phases to get the information submitted. Once you're on site and you have your approved signed proof of residency with housing, then you will be assigned to the specific school based on the address from your proof of residency. We do have 3 to 4 year old preschool programs in our elementary schools. You must live on the installation to attend our 3-year-old and 4-year-old preschool programs, and remain living on the installation to continue them enrolled in the 3- and 4-year-old program. Again, check out our website, virtual tours of all of our schools, 360-degree, walking down some of the hallways, some of those created by our students as well. Very exciting, so please check those out. Another exciting part to Kansas this year, and then our school district, is we were just named a Kansas Purple Star School District, which means we are a school district that supports military families and transitions with activities and resources. Kansas just recently adopted Purple Star program designation this year. We applied and are now Kansas Purple Star School District. And we are, as a school district, always looking for individuals to join our team. So please check out our website if interested. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Anthony Gardner from Fort Leavenworth Palisade. I'm the store director there. We're working on the supply of baby formula distribution. This is just basic information, but I'm telling you, since April 1st, we had a new contract come in to our facility, and we should see a major improvement in our store after that time. Instead of the 20 government workers we have, now we have like 57. Employees, so that's a major, major improvement. Next slide, please. Okay, the sidewalk sale. If you don't know, we have a sidewalk sale coming up May 18th through the 20th. Plus, we have Monster Jam on that first day, which is exciting. We're going to block off the road between the commissary and the exchange, and it's going to be from 2 to 6. Next slide, please. And click to go program. Can't enforce it enough. This is a great program where you can order your groceries online, pick them up after work. Great program. We extended our slots to like brief for half hour. And just a quick thing on that, if you in the slot for more than 10 minutes, please call back. Next slide. These are just basic things that's going on. We have our guest program that's identified through the throughout the store. Those are supposed to be the cheapest bargains in town. Next slide. This is our hiring agency. If you need to go, usajobs.com. It's from WG2, which is a store worker, all the way to the GS14. This is a store director in our office. And we have another military sponsor for them. That is really a good benefit. Next slide. These are just basic hours that we have. Just to inform you, we do open up 30 minutes prior to every day for the handicap agency. And that's it. Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Tim Garish, and I am the store manager of the PX here at Fort Leavenworth. Just have a couple of points that I wanted to bring up today. One, following on what Anthony said about the Monster Jam that will be on the 18th from 2 to 1800. They'll have a display truck there. We'll have the street blocked off between the commissary and the PX. Lots of games for kids, food trucks, lots of different things going on that day. It'll be a great event. Next topic is Doc's Dental is coming to Fort Leavenworth Xchange Mall. Don't have an exact date yet. The plan is for them to open up in July. So that's an exciting addition to the mall. The next thing would be the You Made the Grade program. Straight A students can earn $20, and B average students can earn $10 when they bring us their report card. It's a great program to get kids to study hard and get great grades. That's all we've got this morning.
Paul Oatman's general manager for IHG Army Hotels Fort Leavenworth. I'm glad to be here to see this event today. It's a good thing to bring the community out. We have 321 suites at IHG Army Hotels Fort Leavenworth. All rooms have a full kitchen, have a separate bedroom, living room, separate kitchen and dining area. We're lower than the average per diem rates. We have large suites and we're conveniently accessible to everywhere on Fort Leavenworth. Next slide, please. If you're PCSing in or out, June is the time, July is the time. We have rooms available, so give the hotel a call at 913-364-1301 if you're in the PCS process. We have family-friendly rooms. Every room has a full-size fold-out sleeper sofa in the living room area. And we have rollaways and cribs available. Daily hot breakfast. Every Tuesday night, we have a social at the hotel. All community partners are welcome to that. It's from 5 o'clock to 6:30. We have a seasonal pool. It will open the same hours as the outdoor, same hours and same days as the outdoor pools on post. And we have lots of parking space for box trucks and trailers. High-speed Wi-Fi. The commissary is just across the road. The golf course is just across the road. One gym is right behind the building. Bowling alley is right behind the building. So it's all easily accessible. Next slide, please. So IHG Army Hotels on Fort Leavenworth is a Holiday Inn Express, which is the largest hotel brand for IHG. The main hotel has 308 suites. We also have Historia product, which is for distinguished visitors or retirees. Within that Historia product, we have what's called the Thomas Custer House. They serve a hot breakfast 5 days a week. A little fun fact about IHG Army Hotels: at 321 suites, we are the largest hotel in the state of Kansas, and by size are equivalent to about a 600-room hotel. We are always hiring. If an individual individual is PCSing in from another location and are here for 2 or 3 years, you can take a job with IHG Army Hotels Fort Leavenworth, and you can transfer that to any of the 40 CONUS posts that we're located at. Thank you. Happy day.
Good morning. I'm Bill Wall, the Director of Public Works. If you don't mind, I'm not going to use the podium. Can everybody hear me?
We can.
Great. Okay, so I have exciting engineer projects to brief you on. I'm trying to fall asleep. I just talked to you very back if you get desperate. This is Sherman Army Gate. It's a big project. We're fortunate to get funding from the Army. If you're not familiar with Sherman Gate, Metropolitan is just off the side to your left going north-south. And that building at the bottom is the 35th National Guard Complex, okay? So we have a temporary gate here right now. Temporary canopy, gardens, everything. And we're fortunate enough to get money from the Army to put an Army standard design layout. You can see we're shifting the gate kind of to the north and to the west. And at the end of the day, it's a safer gate for everybody using it. It's more capacity. You should make getting on the installation not a lot faster and easier. Now, that's the good news, right? The bad news is I got to shut it down to fix it. So we'll award in September. Construction will start this fall. It'll probably take about a year, depending on how weather impacts us. And then we'll open sometime late 24, maybe early 25. So when this comes down this fall, we'll get word out to the entire community of how we're going to shift gate capacity around so you can still get on the installation as easy as you can. Any questions on this? So you're really excited about this. Just wait to see the next slide. All right. So it's spring, right? What is spring green? Beautiful weather. It's asphalt season, right? So I have a series of asphalt jobs doing around posts. It might be inconvenient some, but I just want to run through them really quickly. We're doing the SSQ, all three parking lots, the southern lots down the northeast lot there, the large ones getting wrapped up now. We're getting ready to shift to the west lot. We appreciate all the units' patience with that, because we're continuing asking the soldiers to shift their cars around different parking lots as we march through the whole project. But we're getting close. Once we start in that northwest lot, we'll be about a month out. We'll wrap that one up. Next slide. Okay, if you can see the next slide, it would show Wind Avenue, all right? And again, it's kind of hard to see where it is on the installation. That's the Carl Library in the top left, kind of right you. That's historic housing there. And we're doing that street, which is a really pretty bad shape. So we're doing all curb and gutters, sidewalks, the street and everything. It's torn up now. Working closely with our partner and making sure that mail gets delivered, and we're providing access to the moving trucks for folks that are moving out. But this one will be wrapped up by the beginning of June. Actually, we're going to have it done about 2 weeks ahead of schedule because the weather's going to cooperate. Next slide. Okay, Gibbon Ave. This is kind of a sore point with the installation. This one's been done for quite a long time, all right? And the challenge was anytime we dig on main posts in historic areas, we find things that nobody knew were there. So we got into this, tore it all up, and then discovered we had to change the design of the road, which way it slants, where it drains, move inlets around, do all that. It took quite a bit of time. The good news, we're going to wrap this up and have it done here in the coming weeks, weather dependent, okay? So I know that will help everyone, particularly down in the east where the Carl Library and the Gibbon. Next slide. Okay, last one, Grand Pool. Grand Pool's a legacy pool, been around since the 70s, and it's showing its age like me. I got gray hair, it's got a lot of gray hair. So what we're gonna do is we're tearing the bottom out of it right now, and hope to have it open about mid-July. Obviously, that one's weather dependent as well. But that'll set that pool up. It'll be good for another 10 years. So it's a great asset for the communities. They're a great place out in the housing area. Okay, I think that wraps up the engineer projects. Any questions? John, you have anything?
Good.
You speak.
Covered it all.
All right. Yes. All right, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Always, yeah.
Good morning, everyone. My name is April Rogers. I'm with Army Community Service. I run the Employment Readiness Program and the Army Volunteer Corps Program, which to me both go hand in hand with each other. I focus primarily on spouse employment because I'm a former spouse of 20 years, and that's a really important program for me. I connect all of our chambers of commerce or businesses in the area to our spouses who are looking for, you know, employment. And I ensure that, you know, their resumes are ready, their interview skills are, you know, top notch, and I ensure that they are ready to progress in their careers too. I offer one-on-one appointments with them, workshops to goal set, create that career path that they need. If they decide that they cannot work for whatever reason, I also kind of go out to the community, both on and off the installation, to gather those volunteer opportunities for them to, you know, build those skills or keep their skills current. And I offer resume writing for the volunteer so that they can translate those skills. So that's my two programs. If you need to talk to me, I'll be in the back. And next slide. I'm also here to talk about Army Emergency Relief. We currently have a campaign that's getting ready to end soon. We've already raised $25,000, so awesome, Fort Leavenworth, thank you. So if you do need to or do want to donate, please come get with us in the back. So AER is essentially funds for soldiers, by soldiers, essentially. It's soldiers helping soldiers, and it could cover a vast majority of things that are not covered by TRICARE or, you know, the dental program, or if there's an emergency travel need. Did you have something to say about it, ma'am? No?
Okay.
She's a full supporter of AER, so yes, if you guys would like to donate or learn more about the program, we are in the back. Thank you.
Part of the segment where usually I come in and I give like 10-15 minutes of a lot of great activities and events that are happening in a local Fort Leavenworth community and some in the Kansas City area. But for today, I got a high-speed QR code for anyone interested in me highlighting any of those particular events. So you click on the QR code, it's basically going to take you to the Fort Leavenworth activities events page, and it's going to show you all of the great things that we got going on in the local community and in the Kansas City area. And now, I would like to highlight that today is Tuesday. So on Tuesdays and Thursdays, we have our solarium buffet. So for those presenters today and for those who are in attendance, if you are interested in eating in our buffet, we have a discount coupon where you can see Mr. George Morsek over here, and he'll give you one, and you can enjoy some great food Tuesdays and Thursdays, and it doesn't expire until next month. So you don't have to necessarily go this month. You can use it next month.
Friday, Tuesday.
Oh, I said Thursdays. It's Tuesdays and Fridays. I stand corrected. Tuesdays and Fridays. Solarium Buffet here in the FCC. So don't forget to go stop by, see George, and get your discount coupon.
And if you don't get them, I get $100 off on my lunch. So.
Thank you so much for having me. Here are a few events going on around your community. We just opened up this splash pad this weekend. It's located at Hawthorne Park, which is 1100 Ohio Street. The next slide is Bowman Aquatic Center is our local pool that's open Monday, May 29th on Memorial Day, and open swim is daily 1 to 7:30 p.m. Next slide is the Daddy and Me Campout at Bowman Aquatic Center, which is June 10th to 11th, and it's kind of just a campout evening for dads and their kids. Do sign up early if you want to participate because the tickets sell out quickly. Next slide, we have two upcoming dive-in movies. One is July 22nd, and one is right after that on July 28th. One is kind of more geared for children, and one is more an adults-only kind of, you know, have fun without the kids. Maybe we might have some other things going on there. I don't know the movies yet, but look for our website for more information on the City of Leavenworth website. Parks and Recreation is hosting a Christmas in July Bazaar and Flea Market Saturday, July 15th at the Riverfront Community Center. Shopping is 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Vendors are welcome to this event also, but again, they fill up really quickly, so do look at our website if you have something that you'd like to sell at our vendor sale. River City Community Players are a community theater nonprofit, and they utilize our Performing Arts Center at 500 Delaware Street. Upcoming plays include Once Upon a Pine, Oliver, Matilda the Musical, and there's Youth theater programs there. So the next slide is the Camp Leavenworth. It's still a ways out. It's in September, but right now they are signing up for the 5K race that they're going to have, and it's a run walk event. So do look at the campleavenworth.com website for the sign up for that. More information about any of these events are on the City of Leavenworth, Kansas website, leavenworthks.org. Thank you.
Good morning, Fort Leavenworth. The Register of Deeds office is at Walnut and 4th Street in Leavenworth. We offer property fraud alert services, which is a notification service to any landowner in Leavenworth County. So it doesn't apply if you live on post, but if you are off and would like to know what's happening, keep you aware of not only legal, but illegitimate deeds that might be filed. It's called title theft, where identity theft is used to title steal your property. It's conveyed away from you without your knowledge or permission. And unfortunately, we've had over 20 cases in Leavenworth County since 2021. Next slide. We also offer the DD-214s to be filed for free. The information is kept completely confidential. It's under lock and key. If anyone wants a copy of a DD-214 to the veterans, the certified copies are free. If it is genealogy research, they first have to prove their identity and relationship to the veteran before we give that out, and Social Security number is redacted before copies are given. So on behalf of the Register of Deeds office, thank you for your service.
Good morning, Leavenworth, Fort Leavenworth. I'm Christy with the Leavenworth Convention and Visitors Bureau. Glad to be here this morning. Thanks so much for inviting us. Just a couple of quick updates from the Convention and Visitors Bureau. We have a new stakeholders e-newsletter that we're sending out to everyone. If you would like to sign up, please visit our booth in the back and we'll get you signed up for that. Basically, it goes out the first of every month and it includes all kinds of things to be aware of and what's happening in the community. Our visitor guidebook is also back there. It's has a plethora of information on it, restaurants, shopping, attractions, it's just a great handy book to have on your desk for that, just to refer to for things going on. Just a statewide, the Sprint Grant, which is the State Park Revitalization and Investment in Notable Tourism Grant. The State Office of Tourism and the Department of Commerce put $40 million in funds toward this grant. So we've got our fingers crossed. Most all of our museums in Leavenworth applied for this grant, and hoping that at least some of them receive that. We'll keep you posted. Hopefully that'll be out any minute now. So also we have some new CDB stickers, Leavenworth stickers, so you can pick them up back at our booth as well. Wherever you want to put them. So, and also very excited this year, our sister city of Wagga Wagga, Australia will be visiting us. Two young ladies, title holders, will be coming over and spending a week with us. So we will be showing them all over Leavenworth. We're probably going to Topeka for a day and then down to Kansas City for the day as well. So that will be a lot of fun to host them. We haven't had them here since 2018. So very happy to have them back. We are also being visited by our Omi Hachiman Japan sister brotherhood city this July 15th or 16th. Still working on the actual date when they'll be here. It'll be school kids. It's not going to be the contingency from the William Voorhees Foundation, but the school kids, and that will be visiting us. So we're happy to host them as well. So all of this information is included in our newsletter and that, so if you'd like to sign up for that, please let us know. We'd love to get you signed up. That should be it, I think. One more, just a lot of our tourism grants that we put out to the community. February 1st and August 1st are the deadlines to apply. Basically, you can apply for up to $5,000 each time to help you put on your event or
new marketing product that you might be looking at. Some of our group tours that we've hosted this year already, you can read them right there. Some of our trade shows and conferences that we'll be going to this year, and then our calendar of events. Please go on our website. A lot of the events that Melissa with the City of Leavenworth mentioned and some of our other events, we try and do a really good job on our calendar of events for the community. We are constantly looking on Facebook and other areas, other websites and that, to make a comprehensive calendar of events. So it's www.visitleavenworthks.com and then calendar of events. So thank you for your time. Have a great day.
Good morning, I'm Jennifer Goring with the Platte County Convention and Visitors Bureau. So basically, when you cross the bridge, I'm your resource person. So that's our website, visitplatte.com. Get on there, we're in Parkville, Riverside, Platte City, Zona Rosa, Weston, KCI, everything's on there. So use us as you need us. We're happy to be here, happy that you welcomed us. If I could have the next slide. Our Facebook page, that's where everything local, any events, any attractions, any businesses, it's going to be on there. So check out the Platte County Convention and Visitors Bureau Facebook page for the most up-to-date. And come back and see me in the back. We have these great luggage tags that we did for the NFL draft. So it went over very, very well. So now we have to see what we're going to do for World Cup. But Platte County, we've got a lot of things going on. Weston, they've got their May 13th, their Polish Pottery Festival. May 20th, their Weston Wine Fest. Zona Rosa is doing their outdoor concerts, their outdoor park movie night in the park. And then we also have Zona Rosa coupon booklets as well. Parkville, they've got their farmer's market has started. So there's a lot of stuff going on in Platte County, so come visit us. Thank you.
There. I'm Heather with Leavenworth Main Street Board, and we partner with several community partners, some of which you've heard from today, the City of Leavenworth, the Convention and Visitors Bureau. I'll let you read the rest of them. But what we are doing is we are promoting downtown Leavenworth and creating events in downtown Leavenworth. So next slide, please. So this is our save the dates for our scheduled events for the rest of the year. So for Main Street, you want to remember the first Thursday. On the first Thursday of each month, we have an event called Alive After Five, which you can visit several participating. Usually there's about 20 downtown businesses, and there's usually a theme every month. We just had one last Thursday with a Cinco de Mayo theme, where the businesses served little appetizers or drinks, celebrating Cinco de Mayo, but it gives you the opportunity to go into businesses that you may not normally go into. So the Alive After Fives are the first Thursday of every month. And then the other events that we put on are listed up here throughout the year, and we do have back on our table that list if you'd like that. And it's also available on our website. But now that it's officially almost summertime, this farmer's market is every Saturday at Haymarket Square. And then on the second Saturdays of each month, Main Street sponsors the city market, which has some home-based businesses in addition to the actual farmer's market. And also on the second Saturdays during the summertime, we have a concert series, and it's a free concert in downtown Leavenworth. And June 10th is our first concert, and it is Southern Rain. And it's located at Haymarket Square. It's always a fun family event. We always have some type of food vendor, and you can purchase beverages as well. And one last thing is this Saturday, we have a Build a Bouquet event. So you don't know what to get your mom for Mother's Day. For $10 at Haymarket Square, you can buy a mason jar and a map, and you will go to the participating businesses and pick up a flower at each business. And by the end of the day, you have a beautiful flower arrangement that you can give to your mom. So I have flyers for both that Build-A-Bouquet event this weekend and the other events throughout the summer back on the table. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Ann Sobey, and I'm the chairperson for Operation International. Probably most in this room probably don't even know what that is, but we are a program through the Leavenworth Lansing Chamber of Commerce, and our goal is to recruit and provide sponsors for the Leavenworth, for the international students who are coming in for CGSC every year. Currently we have, for this incoming year, we have 125 that will be arriving from 96 countries, and we still are in need of some sponsors. It's a big class this year. This is one of those things, it's not kind of time consuming. I think a lot of people think of foreign exchange programs and think about that's what it is. It is not. You aren't responsible for them getting housing or any of that. That's all taken care of. They're usually the Leavenworth, Fort Leavenworth sponsors. Ours is just to show them, to help them learn about the United States, about Kansas, and especially to show them Heartland America. That's my goal, Heartland America. So if you are interested in this program, we would love to have you join us. And like I say, it is not time consuming, and it is also something that's very fun, educational, an experience that you won't get anyplace else. This is the only place that offers this program is here in Leavenworth and Lansing to these internationals. I want to say thank you for letting me speak this morning, and I'm so glad that the information exchanges are coming back. They used to have them a long time ago, and they were very, very nice to have information from off-post and on-post. So thank you for bringing those back, and thank you for letting me speak.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Taylor. I'm with the Leavenworth Local Hotel. I'm one of the property managers. Our other property manager is Danny Bradbury. She's actually there making sure everything's running properly so I can attend. It's an opportunity to be here. I'm so glad that I was able to make it. We are an old Catholic high school transformed into a newer hotel. We are individually run, so we don't have any point systems. We used to be Wyndham, but we recently got out of it. Our hotel features full and many kitchenettes in our rooms. We have all kinds of activities and fun things to do around our building to keep the kiddos and family occupied while they're with us, including a pickleball court. We are currently opening up our basketball court to have more space at the moment. We are under renovation, so it is closed right now, but we're hoping the middle of this month we'll be back open with a full court, pool table, and lots of more stuff. We are located on Shawnee Street, so we are right in the heart of downtown Leavenworth. Everything is within multiple blocks away from us. We also have a bar on site in case you want a cocktail after a long day of traveling. Head back to your room, enjoy a little quiet time. We have two event spaces open. One of them is the gymnasium, and the second one is the auditorium. It has a PA system. It's got a stage and everything included. And then the next slide, we'll go over some of our events that we have currently running right now. Local Laughs is a local comedy. We bring all kinds of comedians from Kansas City into Leavenworth. It is the third Friday of every month. We open our doors at 7 p.m. and the show starts at 8. Typically, it's about an hour and a half long show. It is free to the community. You just come on in and we will show you exactly where you need to be going. The local market is all kinds of small, at-home, large businesses that reach out to me. We get their booth scheduled. They come in. We try our best to make it on the fourth Saturday of every month, but some dates fluctuate depending on holidays. It includes snacks, clothes, skincare, home decor, Christmas decorations, anything that you can think of that's a craft or an art form that people can make. It is probably at our local markets. And then the last thing is a special event that we have. We try to do quarterly. It's actually a wrestling event. It is professional wrestlers. This one is way ahead of time. It's not until August, but we're currently planning right now because
Well, good morning, Fort Leavenworth. I'm Wesley Boyd. I have the privilege of serving as the CEO for St. John. And first, I just want to thank the community for their support. I know many of you usually interact with us through our urgent care or ED, and we're glad to see you, but we also know that you get your care from Munson, but when they're not there, know that we're here to support you as well. First thing I want to acknowledge and give a thanks to are the military spouses that have been working and have been a part of the St. John team for either the last year, the last few years. As you know, it's a transition season for you, but it's also one for us because we have quite a few team members that are spouses that are getting ready to move on, and we just want to tell them thanks, but also best wishes in the next chapter. What this means for you, though, is I know we have a lot of folks that are moving in, and many of them are healthcare professionals. If you see folks that want to continue their career and do not want to break, please bring them our way. We'll be glad to get them into the healthcare network. Either, you know, we think about it here at Munson, or we have St. John, or we have Providence and others help us put them into a place where they can continue serving the communities and the families in Leavenworth, Lansing, and Fort Leavenworth. The next thing is just want to give folks a heads up that we have a military spouse appreciation tea and dessert bar that we'll be holding on May 12th from 1 to 3 p.m. It's going to be in the St. John Hilltop Cafe and Lobby, and it will also be a small health fair that's going to be focusing on women's health and other issues. We do have quite a few services, and we know that this is one of those, as people move in, it's like, what access do we have in the community, and this is an opportunity introduce those services or connect them where they can get them. On June 1st, we're conducting a ribbon cutting for our new urgent care location. This was something we started about 2 years ago, and we started with just a couple patients on the first day, and now we're seeing 30 to 40 patients in the urgent care every day. How does this impact you? It's really after hours or when you can't get into your primary care physician or others. It keeps folks from going to the emergency department, which is crucial, which can be expensive. We're doing that on June 1st. It's going to be from 11 to 1 p.m. It's an open house as well as a ribbon cutting in conjunction with the Chamber of Commerce. So if you're available, please come see it. It's in the Pavilion Building. It's going to be in Suite 110. New space, a lot more space, greater, enhanced patient flow. So it's a great opportunity for the community. And next thing is just want to offer this, that many folks aren't always sure what you have in the community. You have a very dynamic healthcare infrastructure between Munson, St. John, and the VA. Please look to each one of us before people seek care elsewhere, because I can just tell you, in your community alone, you have ortho, you have GI, you have all the scopes that you need. You have pain management, and we also have OBGYN clinics. And the commitment I have as a CEO for your community hospitals, if we don't have it, we're gonna get you to the best place where you can get it. That's our commitment as your community hospital. Final thing I just ask, like others, if you haven't done so, please like us on your social media accounts so you can stay abreast of all the different things that are going on, not just with St. John, but within healthcare and the Chamber of Commerce within the Leavenworth community. Thank you.
Good morning, thank you. My name is Marcia Irvine. I'm the director for Kansas City, Kansas Community College Pioneer Center, which is located just off of Post, about 5 miles from the front gate at the Old West Middle School. We have a variety of programs. We've added some technical programs. We've got construction, electrical, HVAC, culinary. Our newest, we just added early childhood and criminal justice, so hopefully we will be training up those forces that will be hiring some of those that you will be able to hire in the next few years. We also do all academic programs. Students can get an entire degree in our program, in our building. And then we also offer some great fun community classes. We have the GED program for Leavenworth County, if that is a need. And then we also, as I said, do the community classes. We do some cooking, some other fun things. Looking at doing some kids camps this summer and fall. So visit me back at my table if you'd like any more info. Thank you.
Thank you for having me, and thank you for sitting through so much and being so patient. Now that I'm the end, I'll try to be exciting and keep you all entertained. But it's great to see so many community partners, and I'm really happy to be here. So again, I am Jen. I'm with the Chamber of Commerce, and it's been great to hear our name mentioned so many times. But since this is the first FLIX program, I thought I would tell you just a little bit about what we are and who we are and what we do. and just a little bit of intro as to the chamber. So we are a 501c6, it's a not-for-profit. We don't get any city, state, federal money, but we are made up by completely all of our members. We have about 300 members scattered throughout Leavenworth and Lansing, and we are just totally member-funded, but we do partner with a ton of members in the community, so Main Street Program, the CVB, the EDC for Leavenworth County, and a lot of different businesses. So we work with small businesses, big businesses, nonprofits, but we are here to help with education for our small businesses. We do employment services. We do economic development, government affairs. We work with the cities, to the state, to the capital, and we work in education and even with the military. So we have a lot of robust programs that we can help you with. We've got ambassadors, women's division, a leadership program that we work with KCK, Marsha, wherever I just saw you. She runs our leadership Leavenworth Lansing program. We give out scholarships. We do monthly networking events. Like I said, we have a government affairs and military affairs. We work with the Kansas Military Alliance. And Zoe mentioned and already told you about our Operation International program. So we've got a lot of things that we do to connect. Also, our small businesses and entrepreneurs, we can help those too. So I know there's a lot of spouses that start businesses and then move off post or stay here in our community, and we can help you with that as well. So Grow Leavenworth County, we partner with them to, we even do small business camps and destination boot camps, and we do sponsor a lot of those as well. Main Street Program partners with us on all of those. So if you're looking for any kind of resource in the community, whether it's an event, a business, a class, connections, anything like that, the Chamber is here to help you with that, and we're happy to connect you any way we can. So please let us know how we can help. We are always wanting to do that. So when you think Main Street, you think Thursdays. When you think Chamber, we want you to think Wednesdays. So we've always got something going on Wednesdays. Our downtown partners, we're here for you in any of those ways. So we do have business cards on the back table. Please pick one of those up. We'd love to connect with you. And just let us know. Oh, and if you're part of the Spouses Club, I'll see you and meet you Wednesday night. So thanks so much.
All right. Excuse my voice today. I've got a little bit of laryngitis going. On behalf of the entire community, again, thank you so much for joining us today. What a fantastic event to be able to share information and really just support the community. I just want to give a welcome to, if we have any incoming families, spouses that are listening in to it for us today. We're very excited that you're on your way to the best hometown of the Army. We have fantastic, beautiful installation to live on. So just know that there's a lot of housing opportunities out there. Also, just help us spread the word, right, for today. So if you like what you heard and you want to get this information out to your classmates that are coming in, any permanent party that's coming in, it's very easy. This is a very powerful tool, right? The phone, all you have to do on the Facebook Live app, which I'm on right now, just hit the little right turn arrow at the bottom, hit copy link or share it to a messenger. You can share it text, you can share it email, but the more that you get this out, the better informed that our community will be. So I encourage you, if you can do that, just help us spread the word about all the activities, the businesses, and just everything, all the resources that we have here to offer. we're excited about the future of our community. And at this time, I'll pause. Are there any questions that we can help answer from the audience? All right. Well, hey, thanks again for attending. Don't forget to get your solarium buffet coupon, so that'll help you out. George has those here over to your left, my right. And that buffet will open at 11:30, so in a few minutes. Thank you again for attending. Have a wonderful week ahead.